Welcome back, and in this part of the lesson series, I'm going to be discussing layer one of the seven-layer OSI model, which is the physical layer. Imagine a situation where you have two devices in your home, let's say two laptops, and you want to play a local area network or LAN game between those two laptops. To do this, you would either connect them both to the same Wi-Fi network, or you'd use a physical networking cable. And to keep things simple, in this lesson I'm going to use the example of a physical connection between these two laptops. So both laptops have a network interface card, and they're connected using a network cable. Now for this part of the lesson series, we're just going to focus on layer one, which is the physical layer. So what does connecting this network cable to both of these devices give us? Well, we're going to assume it's a copper network cable, so it gives us a point-to-point electrical shared medium between these two devices. So it's a piece of cable that can be used to transmit electrical signals between these two network interface cards. Now, physical medium can be copper, in which case it uses electrical signals, it can be fiber, in which case it uses light, or it can be Wi-Fi, in which case it uses radio frequencies. Whatever type of medium is used, it needs a way of being able to carry unstructured information. And so we define layer one, or physical layer standards, which are also known as specifications. And these define how to transmit and receive raw bit streams, so ones and zeros between a device and a shared physical medium. In this case, the piece of copper networking cable between our two laptops. So the standard defines things like voltage levels, timings, data rates, distances which can be used, the method of modulation, and even the connector type on each end of the physical cable. The specification means that both laptops have a shared understanding of the physical medium, so the cable. Both can use this physical medium to send and receive raw data. For copper cable, electrical signals are used. So a certain voltage is defined as binary 1, say 1 volt, and a certain voltage as binary 0, say minus 1 volt. If both network cards in both laptops agree because they use the same standard, then it means that zeros and ones can be transmitted onto the medium by the left laptop and received from the medium by the right laptop. And this is how two networking devices, or more specifically, two network interface cards can communicate at layer one. If I refer to a device as layer X, so for example layer one or layer three, then it means that the device contains functionality for that layer and below. So a layer one device just understands layer one, and a layer three device has layers one, two, and three capability. Now try to remember that, because it's going to make much of what's coming over the remaining videos of this series much easier to understand. So just to reiterate what we know to this point, we've taken two laptops, we've got two layer one network interfaces, and we've connected them using a copper cable, a copper shared medium. And because we're using a layer one standard, it means that both of these cards can understand the specific way that binary zeros and ones are transmitted onto this shared medium. Now on the previous screen, I used the example of two devices, so two laptops with network interface cards communicating with each other. Two devices can use a point-to-point layer one link, a fancy way of talking about a network cable. But what if we need to add more devices? A two-player game isn't satisfactory. We need to add two more players for a total of four. Well, we can't really connect these four devices to a network cable with only two connectors. But what we can do is to add a networking device called a hub. In this example, it's a four-port hub, and the laptop on the left and right, instead of being connected to each other directly, are now connected to two ports of that hub. Because it's a four-port hub, this also means that it has two ports free, and so it can accommodate the top and bottom laptops. Now, hubs have one job. Anything which the hub receives on any of its ports is retransmitted to all of the other ports, including any errors or collisions. Conceptually, a hub creates a four-connector network cable, one single piece of physical medium which four devices can be connected to. Now, there are a few things that you really need to understand at this stage about Layer 1 networking. First, there are no individual device addresses. At Layer 1, one laptop cannot address traffic directly at another. It's a broadcast medium. The network card on the device on the left transmits onto the physical medium and everything else receives it. It's like shouting into a room with three other people and not using any names. Now, this is a limitation, but it is fixed by Layer 2, which we'll cover soon in this lesson series. The other consideration is that it is possible that two devices might try and transmit at once, and if that happens, there will be a collision. This corrupts any transmissions on the shared medium. Only one thing can transmit at once on a shared medium and be legible to everything else. If multiple things transmit on the same Layer 1 physical medium, then collisions occur and render all of the information useless. Now, related to this, Layer 1 has no media access control, so no method of controlling which devices can transmit. So if you decide to use a Layer 1 architecture, so a hub and all of the devices which are shown on screen now, then collisions are almost guaranteed, and the likelihood increases the more Layer 1 devices are present on the same Layer 1 network. Layer 1 is also not able to detect when collisions occur. Remember, these network cards are just transmitting via voltage changes on the shared medium. It's not digital. They can, in theory, all transmit at the same time, and physically, that's okay. It means that nobody will be able to understand anything, but at Layer 1, it can happen. So Layer 1 is dumb. It doesn't have any intelligence beyond defining the standards that all of the devices will use to transmit onto the shared medium and receive from the shared medium. Because of how Layer 1 works and because of how a hub works, because it simply retransmits everything, even collisions, then a Layer 1 network is said to have one broadcast and one collision domain. And this means that Layer 1 networks tend not to scale very well. The more devices are added to a Layer 1 network, the higher the chance of collisions and data corruption. Now, Layer 1 is fundamental to networking because it's how devices actually communicate at a physical level. But for Layer 1 to be useful, for it to be able to be used practically for anything else, then we need to add Layer 2. And Layer 2 runs over the top of a working Layer 1 connection. And that's what we'll be looking at in the next part of this lesson series. As a summary of the position that we're in right now, assuming that we have only Layer 1 networking, we know that Layer 1 focuses on the physical shared medium, and it focuses on the standards for transmitting onto the medium and receiving from the shared medium. So all devices which are part of the same Layer 1 network need to be using the same Layer 1 medium and device standards. Generally, this means a certain type of network card and a certain type of cable, or it means Wi-Fi cards using a certain type of antennas and frequency ranges. What Layer 1 doesn't provide is any form of access control of the shared medium, and it doesn't give us uniquely identifiable devices. And this means we have no method for device-to-device communication. Everything is broadcast using transmission onto the shared physical medium. Now, in the next video of this series, I'm going to be stepping through Layer 2, which is the data link layer, and this is the layer which adds a lot of intelligence on top of Layer 1 and allows device-to-device communication, and it's Layer 2 which is used by all of the upper layers of the OSI model to allow effective communication. But it's important that you understand how Layer 1 works, because this physically is how data moves between all all devices, and so you need to have a good fundamental understanding of layer one. Now, this seems like a great place to take a break, so I'm going to end this video here. So go ahead and complete this video, and then when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in the next part of this lesson series, where we'll be looking at layer two, or the data link layer.